The following is a free for download audiobook available on Google Drive. Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 10, Chapter 55, The History of Pradyumna. This chapter tells how Pradyumna was born as the son of Lord Krishna and then kidnapped by the demon Shambhara. It also describes how Pradyumna killed Shambhara and returned home with a wife. Kamadev, Cupid, an expansion of Lord Vasudev, had been burned to ashes by Lord Shiva's anger and was reborn as part and parcel of Pradyumna from the womb of Rukmini. A demon named Shambhara, thinking Pradyumna his enemy, kidnapped him from the maternity room even before he was 10 days old. Shambhara threw Pradyumna into the ocean and returned to his kingdom. A powerful fish swallowed Pradyumna and was caught by a fisherman in a net. They presented the huge fish to Shambhara, and when his cooks cut it open, they found a child within its belly. The cooks gave the infant to the maidservant Mayavati, who was astonished to see him. Just then, Narada Muni appeared and told her who the infant was. Mayavati was actually Kamadev's wife, Rati Devi. While waiting for her husband to be reborn in a new body, she had taken employment as a cook in the household of Shambhara. Now that she understood who the infant was, she began to feel intense affection for him. After a very short time, Pradyumna grew to youthful maturity, entrancing all the women with his beauty. Once, Rati Devi approached Pradyumna and playfully moved her eyebrows in a conjugal mood. Addressing her as his mother, Pradyumna commented that she was putting aside her proper maternal mood and behaving like a passionate girlfriend. Rati then told Pradyumna who they both were. She advised him to kill Shambhara, and to help him, she instructed him in the mystic mantras known as Mahamaya. Pradyumna went to Shambhara and, after angering him with various insults, challenged him to fight, upon which Shambhara angrily took up his club and marched outside. The demon tried various magic spells against Pradyumna, but Pradyumna fended off all of them with the Mahamaya mantras and then beheaded Shambhara with his sword. At that moment, Rati Devi appeared in the sky and took Pradyumna away to Dwarka. When Pradyumna and his wife entered the inner chambers of Lord Krishna's palace, the many beautiful ladies there thought he was Krishna himself, so much did his appearance and dress resemble the Lord's. Out of shyness, the ladies ran here and there to hide themselves. But after a little while, they noticed small differences in Pradyumna's and Krishna's appearances, and once they understood that he was not Lord Krishna, they gathered around him. When Rukmini Devi saw Pradyumna, she felt overwhelmed with motherly love, and milk began to flow spontaneously from her breasts. Noting that Pradyumna looked exactly like Krishna, she became eager to find out who he was. She remembered how one of her sons had been abducted in the maternity room. Quote, "If he were still alive," she thought, "he would be the same age as this Pradyumna standing before me," end quote. While Rukmini reflected in this way, Lord Krishna arrived in the company of Devaki and Vasudev. Although the Lord understood the situation perfectly well, he remained silent. Then Narada Muni arrived and explained everything. Everyone was amazed to hear the account and embraced Pradyumna in great ecstasy. Because Pradyumna's beauty so closely resembled Krishna, the ladies in the maternal relationship with Pradyumna could not help thinking of him as their conjugal lover. He was, after all, the exact reflection of Sri Krishna, and therefore it was natural for them to see him in this way. Text 1. Shukadev Goswami said, Kamadev, Cupid, an expansion of Vasudev, had previously been burned to ashes by Rudra's anger. Now, to obtain a new body, he merged back into the body of Lord Vasudev. Purport. In his Krishna Sandarbha, Acheda 87, Srila Jiva Goswami cites the following verse of the Gopalatapani Upanishad 2.40 to prove that Pradyumna, who is the son of Krishna and Rukmini, is the same Pradyumna who is a member of Lord Krishna's eternal fourfold plenary expansion, the Chaturvyuha. Yatra sho stamsita Krishnas tribi shaktya samahita ramani ruda pradumnanai rukmanya sahito vibhu. Quote, there in Dwarka, the Almighty Lord Krishna, endowed with his full potency, resided in the company of his three plenary expansions, Balaram, Aniruddha, and Pradyumna, end quote. The Krishna Sandarbha goes on to explain, with reference to the present verse of the Srimad Bhagavatam, that, quote, the Cupid whom Rudra burned up in his anger is a demigod subordinate to Indra. This demigod, Cupid, is a partial manifestation of the prototype Cupid, Pradyumna, who is a plenary expansion of Vasudeva. The demigod Cupid, being unable to obtain a new body on his own, entered within the body of Pradyumna. Otherwise, Cupid would have had to remain in a perpetual state of disembodiment, a result of Rudra's having incinerated him with his anger. End quote. In his English rendering of the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1.14.30 purport, Srila Prabhupada confirms the absolute status of Pradyumna, Lord Krishna's first son. Quote, Pradyumna and Aniruddha are also expansions of the personality of Godhead, and thus they are also Vishnu Tattva. At Dwarka, Lord Vasudeva is engaged in his transcendental pastimes along with his plenary expansions, namely Shankarshan, Pradyumna, and Aniruddha, and therefore each and every one of them can be addressed as the personality of Godhead, end quote. According to Srila Sridhar Swami, Pradyumna took birth from the womb of Rukmini before Sri Krishna's marriage to Jambavati and the Lord's other marriages took place. Subsequently, Pradyumna returned from Shambhara's palace. But before Shukadeva Goswami tells of Krishna's pastimes with his other wives, he will narrate the entire story of Pradyumna for the sake of continuity. Srila Sridhar Swami further notes that Kamadev, or Cupid, now appearing within Pradyumna, is a portion of Vasudeva because he is manifest from the element Chitta, consciousness, which is presided over by Vasudeva, and also because he, Cupid, is the cause of material generation. As the Lord states in Bhagavad Gita 10.28, Prajanas kachasmit kandarpa, quote, of progenitors, I am Kandarpa, Cupid, end quote. Text 2. He took birth in the womb of Vidarbha from the seed of Lord Krishna and received the name Pradyumna. In no respect was he inferior to his father. Text 3. The demon Shambhara, who could assume any form he desired, kidnapped the infant before he was even 10 days old. Understanding Pradyumna to be his enemy, Shambhara threw him into the sea and then returned home. Purport. Srila Vishwanatha Chakravarti points out that according to the Vishnu Purana, Pradyumna was kidnapped on the sixth day after his birth. Text 4. A powerful fish swallowed Pradyumna, and this fish, along with others, was caught in a huge net and seized by fishermen. Text 5. The fisherman presented that extraordinary fish to Shambhara, who had his cooks bring it to the kitchen, where they began cutting it up with a butcher knife. Text 6. Seeing a male child within the belly of the fish, the cooks gave the infant to Mayavati, who was astonished. Narada Muni then appeared and explained to her everything about the child's birth and his entering the fish's abdomen. Text 7 and 8. Mayavati was, in fact, Cupid's renowned wife, Rati. While waiting for her husband to obtain a new body, his previous one having been burnt up, she had been assigned by Shambhara to prepare vegetables and rice. Mayavati understood that this infant was actually Kamadev, and thus she began to feel love for him. Purport. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti explains this story as follows. When Cupid's body was burnt to ashes, Rati worshipped Lord Shiva to obtain another body for Cupid. Shambhara, having also come to benediction, Shiva for a benediction, was recognized by the Lord first, who told him, quote, "You should now ask for your benediction," end quote. Shambhara, struck with lust at seeing Rati, replied that he wanted her as his benediction, and Shiva complied. Lord Shiva then consoled the sobbing Rati, telling her, "Go with him, and in this very home you will attain what you desire," end quote. Thereupon, Rati bewildered Shambhara with her deluding power, and taking the name Mayavati, remained in his house untouched. Text 9. After a short time, this son of Krishna, Pradyumna, attained his full youth. He enchanted all women who gazed upon him. Text 10. My dear king, with his bashful smile and raised eyebrows, Mayavati exhibited various gestures of conjugal attraction as she lovingly approached her husband, whose eyes were broad like the petals of a lotus, whose arms were very long, and who was the most beautiful of men. Purport. Mayavati exhibited her conjugal attraction for Pradyumna even before revealing their true identities. Naturally, this caused some confusion at first, as described in the following verse. Text 11. Lord Pradyumna told her, quote, "Old mother, your attitude has changed. You are overstepping the proper feelings of a mother and behaving like a lover," end quote. Text 12. Rati said, "You are the son of Lord Narayan and were kidnapped from your parents' home by Shambhara. I, Rati, am your legitimate wife, O master, because you are Cupid." Text 13. That demon Shambhara threw you into the sea when you were not even 10 days old, and a fish swallowed you. Then, in this very place, we recovered you from the fish's abdomen, O master. Text 14. Now kill this dreadful Shambhara, your formidable enemy. Although he knows hundreds of magic spells, you can defeat him with bewildering magic and other techniques. Text 15. Your proud mother, having lost her son, cries for you like a kurari bird. She is overwhelmed with love for her child, just like a cow that has lost its calf. Text 16. Shukdev Goswami continued, speaking thus, Mayavati gave to the great soul Pradyumna the mystic knowledge known or called Maya, Mahamaya, which vanquishes all other deluding spells. Text 17. Pradyumna approached Shambhara and called him to battle, hurling intolerable insults at him to foment a conflict. Text 18. Offended by these harsh words, Shambhara became as agitated as a kicked snake. He came out, club in hand, his eyes red with rage. Text 19. Shambhara whirled his club swiftly about and then hurled it at the wise Pradyumna, producing a sound as sharp as a thunder crack. Text 20. As Shambhara's club came flying toward him, Lord Pradyumna knocked it away with his own. Then, O king, Pradyumna angrily threw his club at the enemy. Text 21. Resorting to the black magic of the Daityas taught to him by Maya Danava, Shambhara suddenly appeared in the sky and released a downpour of weapons upon Krishna's son. Text 22. Harassed by this rain of weapons, Lord Rukmineya, the greatly powerful warrior, made use of the mystic science called Mahamaya, which was created from the mode of goodness, which could defeat all other mystic power. Text 23. The demon then released hundreds of mystic weapons belonging to the Guyakas, Gandharvas, Pisachas, Uragas, and Rakshasas, but Lord Karshni, Pradyumna, struck them all down. Text 24. Drawing his sharp-edged sword, Pradyumna forcibly cut off Shambhara's head, complete with red mustache, helmet, and earrings. Text 25. As the residents of the higher planets showered Pradyumna with flowers and chanted his praises, his wife appeared in the sky and transported him through the heavens back to the city of Dwarka. Text 26. O King, Lord Pradyumna and his wife resembled a cloud accompanied by lightning as they descended from the sky into the inner quarters of Krishna's most excellent palace, which were crowded with lovely women. Text 27 and 28. The women of the palace thought he was Lord Krishna, and when they saw his dark blue complexion, the color of a rain cloud, his yellow silk garments, his long arms and red-tinged eyes, his charming lotus face adorned with a pleasing smile, his fine ornaments, and his thick, curly blue hair. Thus the women became bashful and hid themselves here and there. Text 29. Gradually, from the slight differences between his appearance and Krishna's, the ladies realized he was not the Lord. Delighted and astonished, they approached Pradyumna and his consort, who was a jewel among women. Text 30. Seeing Pradyumna, sweet-voiced, dark-eyed Rukmini remembered her lost son, and her breasts became moist out of affection. Text 31. Srimati Rukmini Devi said, "Who is this lotus-eyed jewel among men? What man's son is he, and what woman carried him in her womb? And who is this woman he has taken as his wife?" Text 32. "If my lost son, who was kidnapped from the maternity room, were still alive somewhere, he would be of the same age and appearance as this young man." Text 33. "But how is it that this young man so much resembles my own Lord Krishna, the wielder of Sharinga, in his bodily form and his limbs, in his gait and the tone of his voice, and in his smiling glance?" Text 34. "Yes, he must be the same child I bore in my womb, since I feel great affection for him and my left arm is quivering." Text 35. As Queen Rukmini conjectured in this way, Lord Krishna, the son of Devaki, arrived on the scene with Vasudeva and Devaki. Text 36. Although Lord Janardana knew perfectly well what had transpired, he remained silent. The sage Narada, however, explained everything, beginning with Shambhara's kidnapping the child. Text 37. When the women of Lord Krishna's palace heard this amazing account, they joyfully greeted Pradyumna, who had been lost for many years, but who had now returned as if from the dead. Text 38. Devaki, Vasudev, Krishna, Balaram, and all the women of the palace, especially Queen Rukmini, embraced the young couple and rejoiced. Text 39. Hearing that lost Pradyumna had come home, the residents of Dwarka declared, quote, "Ah, Providence has allowed this child to return as if from death," end quote. Text 40. It is not astonishing that the palace women, who should have felt maternal affection for Pradyumna, privately felt ecstatic attraction for him as if he were their own lord. After all, the son exactly resembled his father. Indeed, Pradyumna was a perfect reflection of the beauty of Lord Krishna, the shelter of the goddess of fortune, who and appeared before their eyes as Cupid himself, since even those on the level of his mother felt conjugal attraction for him, then what to speak of how other women felt when they saw him. Purport. As Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti explains, whenever the palace women saw Sri Pradyumna, they immediately remembered their lord, Sri Krishna. Srila Prabhupada comments as follows in Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Quote, Srila Shukadeva Goswami has explained that in the beginning, all the residents of the palace, who were all mothers and stepmothers of Pradyumna, mistook him to be Krishna and were all bashful, infected by the desire for conjugal love. The explanation is that Pradyumna's personal experience or appearance was exactly like Krishna's, and he was factually Cupid himself. There was no cause of astonishment, therefore, when the mothers of Pradyumna and other women mistook him in that way. It is clear from the statement that Pradyumna's bodily characteristics were so similar to Krishna's that he was mistaken to be Krishna, even by his mother. End quote. Thus end the purports of the humble servants of His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada to the 10th canto, 55th chapter of the Srimad Bhagavatam, entitled The History of Pradyumna.